you know he's already myself, Billythegoat. Welcome back to another episode of Trenchtalkz with P110. As you can see, we're all the way in Ireland today. We're here in Drogheda and I'm linking the A92, so they're going to be taking me around the ends. And yeah, man, let's see what's going on. We've got Nick over there. You're telling me, my bro, man.
Usual.
Come on, man.
Yeah, man. Bro, sorry about that.
But yeah, man, so yeah, we're just going to see what's going on, man. We're just going to see if it takes us around the ends, though.
Okay, so like, basically, how it works was, obviously, the man them, they started rapping ages ago.
Yeah.
So they, we end up like, we are Saffa, we're like, okay, cool. Like, officer started doing the first come, and then like all these guys, they were rapping for ages. Like, I know all these man for time, man. This guy used to be freestyling. If I seen some of his freestyles from the park days, bro. And
yeah, literally, man used to just go to the park and just freestyle.
And then we're like, yeah, fuck it, man. You come rap. Niggas were looking for studios. Obviously, this guy actually, at the start, like, he helped us a lot, do you know what I mean? Because that's where we just go there. He wouldn't charge us for sessions, whatever. Well, he would, but not too much. And then, like, it was like, okay, cool. Like, fuck, we have a banger. We have songs already made. And obviously, I was just kind of freshly new at the thing at the start. So obviously, Saffo, he was managing Officer at the start. And he was like, okay, cool. And I sent him some of the work that we had already done. So we had already done, like, paid for the beats, visuals, mixes. Everything was done. The only thing was about uploading, like, where to upload it. So he was like, nah, fuck this. Like, these men are cold. Sent it to a label. Label signed the man down.
Oh, swear down.
What? Lockdown 2020. Was where I was like, okay, calm. Do you know what I mean? Like, we're bored. Like, let's actually find ourselves. You know what I mean? I feel like that 2020 lockdown, as long as it was shit in that, but it actually helped people find who they really are. Do you know?
Okay, well, we're getting up to the place where I shot my first.
Your first ever music video?
Yeah.
Silly bang.
Young Nicks, I was nice till a Nick touched bro like twice. Huh? Now I get round there with a 15, ain't finna stop till a up boy dies.
Well, so
you see,
you, man, yeah, were you, like,
born and raised in Drogheda? Yeah, bro. Yeah. I was born in
Cork
still, I won't lie. Oh, Cork? Yeah, but I was raised here.
When did you move to Drogheda, then?
Oh. I was young. You know, I lived in Nigeria for a bit.
That's fair.
And then I came here, I can't remember what age, but I was like 6, 7.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I was 7 when I came here. Because, obviously, I was born in Cork, stayed there for a bit.
Yeah.
Back to Nigeria. Then I was, like, 6, 7. Came here, straight to Drogheda. From there, obviously, understanding.
Obviously, you lot are still like, I still class you as pioneers when it comes to Irish rap. You get what I'm trying to say to you, but like, do you like, what like the struggles? Because you were like one of the first to do it, you get me?
Yeah.
So, like, what, was it hard actually getting started? Like,
yeah, fact, like, getting started, like, it was kind of new, even the parents and that, it was kind of new to them, like the aunties, because obviously, my mum's friends used to see me, obviously, with a ballet on and that type of thing. So, it was kind of new to them, but like, now, they see me, they kind of know me as Nick's, innit?
Yeah.
I went to something for my brother the other day, and I seen a few uncles that I ain't seen at the time. And usually they call me David, innit? That's my government name, innit? So they just call me Nick's. And Nick's are like, oh yeah, see what I'm doing.
Where's the name Nick's come from?
Yeah, my surname, innit?
Literally.
It was one of my guys. Gaz, he gave me that name still. I'd say we entered at a nice time, innit?
Yeah, you did, you did.
Yeah.
The time that man entered was like, okay, cool. It's not gone yet, but it's gone. I kind of needed it.
It was
still quiet, like it was, because what happened was, you know, I always say this within music, music always picks up and then it goes, kind of drops back down.
Yeah.
And it was like, okay, cool. The guys that had their time, so you say like AV9, Online, they had their time. And then it was like, okay, cool. There's a period where like artists like to take a break and kind of like, okay, see what they can do to the work, add on to the work. So the niggas were like, okay, cool, boom. We already know what we're gonna do. Hopped straight in and then kind of carried it again. Do you know what I mean? I brought it to a new level. Now it's just a matter about keeping and progressing in that level that you're trying to aim for. Do you know what I mean? So, say, there was struggles. I feel like people also didn't really take in the music. Even now to this day, like you guys have like BBC, like big platforms supporting you in Ireland. You can say, there is a little bit of support, but it's not in the genre that we're in. So kind of like it's a bit sticky in that sense.
Even like I said this to you when we done the podcast, innit? Like in every scene, there's someone that's the first people to do it, which you say like the AV9, the 090, Then there's the people that are coming and like take it to the next level. You feel me? I feel like that's where you came in. Like that plugged in, took Irish music to the next level. And my thing is like, at what point did you look at the Irish scene and think like, rah, like this is actually going, like this is actually gonna get big?
When was it? We've seen, it's just the recognition that we were getting. Like, Like when the man them's on the plugged in, like the a few big names are reaching out to them in terms of mentioning them on Insta and that type of thing. And that's just when it was just like, whoa, like okay, people are actually have eyes on us, you get me, that type of thing. Where it was just like we just got from there, we just got head screwed on innit. It was a madness still, it was mad, I can't lie.
There's another spot there that we always used to chill in as well. Yeah. This is the main strip, bro. You'll see 100 niggas down at McDonald's now before we ate the music thing even started. Yeah. To be our spot, these benches, you just see us post here from morning to night, man.
Yeah, you see them times, yeah, beef was like, it was, like there were no dingers or nothing like that. Yeah. Niggas were taking bus because obviously we were young, innit? So obviously, the Mackie D's is right across from the bus stop. So so as them man they are pulling up, we're obviously at Mackie D's and you can already see it, you get me? So it was just mad.
Yeah.
I remember niggas will see the bus from here, be like, oh my god, there's the 101. Because that's the bus that them man would take or we'd take to go to Dublin anyway, you know, the Dublin direction. They'd be like, oh, look, there's the 101 there. You don't see niggas just standing up on the thing looking around ready, man. Nah, well, fuck that, man.
Come on.
Yeah, working on a song.
Yeah, working on a song,
right? Oh, swear. It's rap, spit something then.
Paddy's working on a song.
Yeah. Make sure you look.
Stay tuned, yeah. It's Paddy McKay from Drogheda.
No.
Not from Drogheda?
No. Where you from? I live in Curran. Are you okay?
Am I okay? I'm fine.
Are
you okay?
Yeah.
Good, man.
Yeah. Go on, Paddy. Go on. Cameras on you, Paddy. Go on.
Paddy, you're not going to buy your shirt, though?
No, I don't push it. Look at this. It's a song. It'll be like this. Dirty booty.
Yeah.
Oh, woo.
Yeah.
Dirty booty.
Yeah.
Oh, woo.
Yeah.
Dirty booty.
Yeah.
High booty.
Yeah.
Big money,
yeah.
All my time is crazy. Oh, that girl. Got that. All my time is crazy.
Yeah.
She's watching the east and watching the west. She's like, I love fashion and food.
Keep going. Come on, man.
Your heart.
Got a BT. Oh, you might introduce yourself actually, bro. Yeah, Nick, we talked to you already, man.
Yo, confirm Charlito, get to know. Or don't know. Crease out right now, go stream it.
Action. Biggest and baddest producer at Ireland. No, the pan.
We got Kevin in the building as well.
Why you dozing off? Enter this
song. We're introducing ourselves. Obviously, it's man like Kebs. Get to know. I don't get to know.
Easy. Do your own thing.
I'm K-Sap as well.
Yeah, it's K-Sap, you know, the one and only.
Where you get that mask from, bro?
When I get a mask? Yeah. It's actually a funny story, actually. When I started rapping, one of my boys from secondary school, he said he has a mask, innit?
Mm.
And he said it was a gold mask. So I'm thinking it's a gold balaclava or something. So I was like, yeah. Pass. Then as soon as I got it, it was one of these, innit? And I was like, do I want to use this?
Yeah.
And then I brought it to the man then, and I think BT was there for, do you remember that, what was that shoot that we were shooting? I think it was me and Ace's first song.
I can't remember.
Was
it Hunter X Hunter?
No. But anyway,
no business, man.
I brought this there to the man then, and the man then was like, yeah, it's cold. So I just kept it, you get me? So yeah. Okay,
Seth. What is it? Is it broke at the bottom or do you
This one's for my shows, isn't it? So I just, because I couldn't find my other one, so I brought this one. This one, I had to cut the mount because when I was performing, the sound was muffled, isn't it?
Oh, so I feel it. How come you chose to wear the mask though?
How come I chose to wear it?
Yeah.
At the start, to be honest, I just didn't want my mom to know I was rapping.
What are you saying? I'm Nigerian?
Yeah.
You're a bar?
Yeah.
So
what is it? But my first song that I put out, yeah, she knew it was me immediately.
How?
My voice.
It's your mom and she didn't just tell, bro.
And then just kept it on. Mm. I just like my privacy, you know.
I feel you. Well, do people know it's you though? Do
people in Drogheda know it's me, do you get me? Because I'm known in Drogheda, so it's like a thing where even some people in Dublin might know it's me, but the majority of Ireland don't know who's behind the match, and that's what I like. So yeah, it's calm.
Obviously got Andre in part as well, man.
We got De La Ba, you already know what it is, your boy 100 Results, aka Dre Boots, aka Mr. Royal Blue, aka the one and only. You said you better if you don't get it, forget about it.
Yeah, bro. And on Trap Boy BT, the realest rapper out here, ain't no more to be said.
Well, obviously, man grew up here in Dublin, innit? So I kind of know how it gets, but like, from the outside looking in, people won't think that in Ireland, like, street shit happens. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, people won't ever think that.
Street shit happens everywhere,
right? Yeah, I know that's what I'm saying, but like, you know how people are ignorant, though, innit?
UK zone was more, obviously, more.
But you know what? Do you know what? So mad to me, yeah. Like, people's, yeah, you said that, innit? And that's what a lot of people think. But it's a thing where, just because niggas aren't killing themselves on the street doesn't mean people aren't going through a tough time where they're raised, you know what I mean? So like,
we're people born 2001, 2000, 2002, we're still first generation black people here.
Yeah, fact.
So like, we're the ones that are kind of like making our voices a bit heard now. So
you're setting the pace, isn't it?
Exactly, so people all over the world are starting to understand that, whoa, Ireland is not just full of, you know, leprechauns and white people that do their own thing. Like, we're still here doing our own thing.
People think that it's only like the black people that are causing trouble.
Yeah. Bro, the white people are the worst, bro. The white people are the worst.
Oh, this is dirt country, you know.
It doesn't matter that this is what you do,
They're the worst, bro.
Bro, even in this end that we're in, niggas will even be saying, oh yeah, the island doesn't defend, bro. There's crazy shit everywhere, man.
No, but that's one thing I wanted to ask you a lot, though, because like when you might mention the UK, I feel like on the street side of things, like there's people that like were born into that lifestyle, and people that they kind of chased after it. So with you lot over here, like, would you say that you man chose that life, or like was it just something that you was around?
Good questions.
Be honest though.
Do you know what
it's
it is?
It's a choice, isn't it?
It's a choice for everyone.
Yeah, 100%.
It's a choice for everyone. Life is a choice. You know what I mean? 100%. So I feel like people saying that, like, oh, they were born in. I mean, you can still leave. Like, you can leave. If you really wanted to. You don't have to be involved in this.
Bro, do you know how many friends I know that got shipped back to a boarding school in Nigeria, bro?
Yeah, bro. Like, if you really don't want to be here, you don't have to be here. So, it's just a thing of, like, it's your circumstances.
But what made you choose that, though?
I go around, bro. If I'm being, bro, I don't want to live this life.
Bro, it's a better life.
Do you get me?
What's a better life?
Like, well, when people make these choices, if you're making the choices for the right reasons, it's to better your life, because the system that we're all, you know, put in school to learn is a system that I personally think you can't win.
Yeah, but continue what you're saying, though.
But like, they're trying to tell you that you can be something better, but like, at the end of the day, you're going to work, you're going to go to college, you're going to do all that just to what? Probably earn the same amount that they're earning.
So average life.
You know what I mean? If you want to learn to make money, you might as well learn from someone who's making money, and the people who are making money were
illegal,
involved in that.
So it's more of like a role models kind of thing.
Yeah, like as bad as it sounds, and the shit that comes with it. Like that's what it is.
But you see how you said, oh, it's bad. Yeah. I think good and bad are relative concepts.
Yeah, 100%.
I feel like, you know, in your circumstances, you get to determine what's good and what's bad. Mm. Do you get me? Like, you can look at all these other people that are born into good families with money and all that, you know. They look at us and think, oh, these people are bad, they're hooligans, all of that. Then you look at someone who's, then you talk to someone who's born in a poor family, who's in the streets, and then you don't look, and then you understand what they're coming from. You know, like, oh, you get me? I think, so that's why I think, like, oh, all this good, bad, all this concept. It's all what you decide what's good and what's bad.
And you could always make good out of bad anyway.
Yeah,
you get what I'm trying to say? And even what you said here about like people that are born into rich families, for example, like there's life lessons that they'll never be able to learn.
Exactly.
They've always had it by a silver spoon, you get me?
Exactly.
That's what I'm saying to you.
That's why people like, they don't go through what we've gone through.
Yeah.
You get me? So it's like, I think it betters you, if anything. Like, it teaches you a lot about life.
It makes you grow faster.
It does.
100% it does.
Like, you can be a man at 18 and still be a boy at 40 years old.
Yeah, exactly.
You get me? It's all about what you learn as a kid.
Mm. At the same time, you have to have a bit of discretion in it as well.
Yeah.
So, like, for us doing music, you would all, like, if we're trying to change our lives in music, it would almost be a better thing to, you know, get out of the streets. And a lot of people are getting out of the streets. And like, even though sometimes you maybe think, people think and they think that they understand what people are going through, but like, at the same time, you need to understand that, like, even for me, for example, like,
I know my parents tried with me, so like it's not like I'm trying to disrespect them in any way.
Yeah.
Or anything, but like it was just wanting more for myself.
Mm.
And wanting to be able to do more, because I know there's people that can go through life, you know, living off their parents till they're what, 23 and that. But you know, some people when they turn 15,
they want to be independent.
They want to do their own thing.
Even them, I need to remember that like, our parents did like outmost best to provide for us, you feel me? So it's
like, bro, they've left where they've came from. They brought us here. They've already made it. Yeah. And the thing is, it's like paving the way for people, you know, still to come, because like we were saying, we're first generation black people here, so like there's probably a lot of younger black guys that maybe thought they would never get their voices heard in this country, maybe. Because you left Ireland and went to England. I know hundreds more people that did the exact same thing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? And then they'll go to England, they'll do what you're even doing, like, you know, start doing what they need to do. Like, some people feel like they can't do that here, but like,
that's another thing. Like,
do you know what I mean?
It feels like MD, you know, we're paving the way for youths to, you know, just because you're from Ireland, just because you're from Drogheda, of all places, don't mean you can't be successful. That's another thing that, you know, that we're trying to promote, that you can be anything you want to be in this world. You just need to put your head down and stick to it.
Trust me, the last 5 years of doing music in this country, the amount of new artists that come up every week, and they're not going to come and say, yo, N92, I won't lie, you man, you know, gave me the encouragement to do this.
But deep down you know it.
But deep down you kind of know that, everybody knows, as much as we all like to say we don't like to follow other people, once one person starts something, it gives you, you know, kind of the motivation to do it. You know what I mean? To kind of do the same thing, even if it's in your own way.
Yeah,
Nicks.
Are you young boys? You got a studio in the barbershop?
No, we just gotta do what we gotta do.
I feel you, man. I can't, like, Ireland, the only country you ever see a studio in a barbershop.
Yeah,
man. I've never seen that. I've never seen that. Like,
studio as well. You
lead to everything. Yes.
Can I see it?
If you want, yeah, feel free.
Thank you.
Saying this is the studio you man started off in.
Yes.
Yeah, beginning.
Obviously, Nick, you've answered this question already, but for you, man, yeah, like, what was it that actually made you man start taking music seriously?
If I'm being honest, it was Office on BT, you know, that made me take it seriously. Because I started writing like late 2017, but I never showed anyone. And then Office on BT came out with their first tune. And then it was just a thing, everybody took it like really well. So I was like, oh, if they can do it, I can't die. You know? So then I showed the officer. Yeah,
like apart from these lot, I kind of have like a different-ish type of backstory, because like before they even started doing music, I was doing music like way back. Do you get me? And when I started doing it, like the scene wasn't anything like crazy. It was just like me and a few people, and it was hard, innit? So then obviously when Officer comes along, like he literally just came and opened up like a new like level of just like, okay, cool.
He brought new eyes to the
scene. You get me? You can be from Ireland and you can make it. When I saw him do what he was doing, I was like, crazy. Like, he literally came and did what me and a few others were trying to do for years in a year. That's crazy. You get me? That's why for him, you always have to hats up. Like, if you don't like him, whether you like him, you have to give him credit where credit is due.
Because that's one thing.
Fam, he did his thing.
Let me just add to that. Good story, though. But before that, there's always a story before that. Mm-hmm. When Officer was starting off, before them, it was him first. It was Morris, when we're going to start the rap group, right? Mm-hmm. You brought him first, next.
I can't remember.
Remember next?
Bro, them days in the park.
And then remember, Officer, you brought Officer down.
I remember,
Officer to come and rap, you brought BT down. So it was him that was like pushing them, like they were already rappers.
Yeah, manager after manager.
It was like, yo, let's do it more. So Morris was there from the start.
I see the stories that MF was bringing Nick to the school.
You don't see it?
Yeah,
the
tracks
here was in year 3 or something. So Morris was there from the start.
The Office is like, he's in a great position now compared to where he used to be. But it's like, you know, like when rappers go clear, yeah, this thing about like them like not really wanting to still be associated with the people they came up with, because they might be negative influences, them kind of things. But like with you, man, like would you say that you like he still stayed in touch and he still continued to push you, man, on as well?
Yeah, definitely. That's collective as well. When he was gone, like obviously people knew him. That's when he was like, okay, cool, I'm gonna do something with the A9 link up. Boom. Everyone was on that. Gave everyone a spotlight because everyone had their own space, own scenes. You get me? then obviously the Plugged In as well. He's like, the Plugged In was supposed to be just him someone else. I think it was probably him and Debo. He's like, nah, cool, let's add on BTK Sal. Boom, went viral, do you know what I mean? So he's helped a lot. He's been, he's obviously doing his own thing, but he never forgets about the Mandem, for sure. Like, so I was like, cool, if I'm doing this, bring the Mandem along, do you know what I mean? Or if I'm gonna write this, Nix, listen to that beat, see if you like it, do you know what I mean? That's how he's always been, and that's how he stayed. Like, the guy's been humble through his process. From the start, he's a humble guy, like, do you know what I mean? So,
but like, even with the Plugged In, though, obviously you had like the iconic verse, I must have swing my arm the figure eight and that. Like, so talk to me about like the writing process for that Plugged In as well.
That day was funny.
Funny day. But you see, I wrote that first line, the first verse, I wrote that like maybe a few weeks before I even knew I was going to the Plugged In. So I wrote for something else, right? And then the second pair, by God's grace, I don't end up alive, but that pair was actually supposed to go on the song with me and this girl, right? Okay, do you remember I recorded that in your guys?
Yeah. Do you not even know what happened? We did it in my studio, yeah, and the files corrupted. Oh, I remember I shout out K-Sav. Yeah. Go to K-Sav, I go, yo, he goes, yo. God, I won't lie, the file corrupted. He goes, say, swear. I'm like,
that,
wow.
That's a blessing, this guy.
So then, when Shuffle told us that we're going to do it, we went to Dublin, because this is the first time we're all going to UK for music, innit? So this is like a huge step in our career. So we went to the Paris studio in Dublin. We were recording, it was me, BT, Officer and Debo. And Officer and Debo were supposed to record their Mad About Paris, right? So they recorded that, and they took a while, right? So then, I think we were there like 11, or even earlier. 11. And then we didn't leave till like, maybe like six right? You were there as well, didn't you? So fucking,
I would have been vexed if I was there.
We didn't even, I don't even know where we were recording, right? But we only got
for beats, bro.
Yeah, we were looking for beats. For
7 hours looking for beats.
And this guy, I won't lie, it was my
guy in the world for beats.
Because they were playing beats, all the man were saying they were liking it. I was like, no. And BT finally picked the actual Plugged In beat, right? Then I go, I don't like it, right? Then they were like, just spit it. So I spat the first one, and then it was then, I think, who went in next? Was it you that went in next, or Debo?
Debo.
Debo went in, then BT, then Officer. So we all had original four verses, right? And then that's when we stopped there, and then we went home, played it in the car, we're like, okay, this sounds cool. When we got to England, it was a thing of like, we went to the studio, and then,
well, don't forget that long journey. For an hour and a half, they played the beat.
No, not even. I'm not even talking about film studio. Remember when we went to a studio? This was when we went to England.
In Woolwich. When we went to Woolwich. Remember when we went to Woolwich?
Yeah.
In IG that time.
He's talking about the sprint.
Recording for the whole day, but we couldn't record.
We didn't record the
because we're all fried.
Yeah.
I'm tired.
No. They didn't come with this.
It was
just me, this guy, Debo, and
the head was there.
Yeah, but we were all just fired. We couldn't finish the song.
Bro, niggas were sleeping in the studio. Saf was there saying, yo, you have a Plugged In tomorrow. You guys need to write. But I just...
Oh, so you didn't, even the day before, you had no bars?
Bro, we hadn't finished it. Like, all we had was basic, you know, status.
Like, the only thing I had anyway was the first line, right? So I didn't even add the By God's Grace thing yet till we were in the car till film studio. Now that was like a 2.5 hour journey.
Yeah, that's what Charles said.
And that's when that's the story that everybody knows. We played that beat for 2.5 hours, yeah.
Over and over again.
Nobody's talking, everybody's just running, yeah. Nobody's talking to anybody, everybody's just talking, right? So when we got there, everybody's like, we're done. So like, okay, cool. So when we got to the films, they were like, who's gonna go first? I'll go first. Debo, and then boom. My track just. And at the time when I heard it, I was like, meh, this song is just a mess song. Like, it's not even that sick. So,
that's kind of my first reaction as well. Before it went viral, I thought like, this is cold, but it's like,
I didn't take anywhere. It was nothing like spectacular or what it was gonna do. And when we heard it, the first time we heard it, we didn't get the actual song because films were scared that, you know, it could get leaked. So he sent us just the voice recording, innit? And we heard it, and man, we were like, yeah, this is crazy. Mm. And then we played it. I think the first week it was going calm. Yeah. Then it's when the second week kicked off, that's when it started.
started going crazy.
TikTok is like a cheat code in this thing, bro. Even like, even with what I do, like the podcast and that, bro, like, that's how man became known through TikTok, you feel me? And like, even with you, like, especially Debo's part as well. Yeah. Like, that shit went crazy.
It's
on
the
TikTok.
One that's,
what? I said, when Debo walks his dog tells people Debo don't bite. I don't know how they think this kind of shit.
Bro, the stupidest things.
You know what I mean? But like, what was the reception when you came back to Ireland after like the plug? Obviously, you came back to Ireland before it came out, innit?
Mm. Yeah.
But saying when it came out though, like, what changed for you, man?
Everything.
Mm.
Even the respect before it came out.
Yeah, like,
even before it came out.
The fact that man had a plug in was
everything.
Like,
everything was already kind
of
changed.
All that type of shit.
Cause like around that period, I won't lie, I think everybody kind of knew that something was really changing. Like everything about
what we're
doing was different.
You can feel something.
Yeah.
I remember popping champs like every week.
Even the day
the plugged in was dropping, I remember we were in your house, innit? We're in Kay's house, all of us are there. We're all just waiting for it to drop. And the thing is, even when I'm going on Snapchat, it's like everybody else was waiting for it to drop.
That day is probably one of the most iconic days.
Because
it's actually so mad because it was me, BT, and then like a few of our other boys just in my own gap, right? Just on my laptop, fucking just waiting for the song to come on, right? And when it comes on, everybody's going crazy in my house. My Snapchat's going off, his Snapchat's going off. Bro, we're just smoking joints, we're just having a good time,
and
man.
Just breaking chairs.
And then, bro, everything's just... everything's just crazy, bro.
And then the thing is, even for, like, the next day we were waking up, I'm pretty sure you probably saw, next day, waking up, 500 new followers.
Bro, it's mad.
Every day, the followers are going up, you're getting tagged in this.
They started hitting me up from places, bro.
Even as a group, we don't want to be confined to that one plugged in forever. Like, the thing is, we have so much more talent on songs that probably people may or may not know. So like, for us to just be held on, you know, 3 bars from 4 people.
Exactly.
Is a bit, so like, you know, we'd rather probably even, you know, make our own tune together and that even smash the plug in, do it better, and then know that, we did this just us. Do you know what I mean?
I like they said that.
As much as we did it together, we did it with Fumes. Like, we know it's us, but like, you know, there's still that feeling that like you want to do it by yourselves, because like
100%.
Even though we got a million on the plug in and the millies came a week after a week,
million.
I remember when we got a million on the In and Link Up, and that one just felt more, you know, kind of more real, because
it was
I wish up, tell me what you know about Ain't I Link Up, get me on me. I remember the days we were in a studio in Termofecken outside Drogheda. We, like, this was during lockdown. I remember Safo in the group chat, MF in the group chat, literally like, yo, man, them, okay, there's lockdown, there's not much to do, let's go studio, let's start this brand that we've been saying we were going to build. Because, like, it was like kind of a, we always kind of were doing start and stop, like, it was a thing, and like, K-Sav, Nyx, they were recording their tunes, they recorded a few tunes, a few months would go by, I would record my tune, a few months would go by, me and Kebs would record our tune, a few months would go by, so it was like, a thing of like, okay, man, them, we're going to get a plan now, we're going to do this, let's do it, and then when you see your own work, you know, bringing rewards from just you, there's nothing better than that, there's nothing better than that.
See, me personally, I rap about my circumstances, I rap about my life and all that shit, bro. But then a lot of Irish rappers, they just want to rap drill. Bro, be yourself. Literally, rap about stuff that's actually known to you. All this talk about doing the maddest stuff, don't be doing that. You don't be doing that, so why lie? Why rap about it? You know? Actually, rap about shit you go through, bro. You don't have to be the most intense shit, but at least it's real.
Exactly.
You get me? And that's what I appreciate. I appreciate real music. Like it don't even matter if it's shit. But if what you're saying is real, it will touch me, because I'm like, all right, cool. This guy is actually trying to express himself. And that's what I do. That's because music allows me to, you know, because I don't like speaking about my feelings or speaking any other type of way. So the music speaks for me. Do you get me? So me personally, I like to rap about my life, creative. Do you get me? But then other rappers just wanna rap drill, ching, all of this type. Oh no, you're not on. You get me? So
this is Trenz Barbershop, number one in Drogheda. Boss on Khalid Trenz. You already know this is where everything started from. The bass. The structure in our careers, And obviously we give this man all the praise that he deserves. Because you already know this is our spot, man. Niggas have got their tattoos done here, record their first tracks here, got their haircut here. Do you know what I mean?
Bro, I'm not even gonna lie, yeah. You see this guy, gave me my first trim. Before, you know, no matter, he used to braid my hair.
First tattoos. First tattoos for the man.
But obviously, with you, like, you've watched all of these men grow into what they are now. So, like, how is it for you, like, just being a local and seeing, like, the progression of people from your area?
I tell you what, it's actually very impressive. You know, sometimes you try and help the youths, but they don't help themselves.
Exactly.
But this youth here, all we did was just a little bit of push, and they did everything themselves. So, big up to them, more grace to their
own. And you see the thing with, like, aunties and uncles around this place, it's like, they try to, you know, wash you.
Yeah.
He never done that. It was guidance, you know. Even like he was our friend.
Even before the music. You come here, you get a haircut. You would have just your whole life.
This is where we hang out. This is where I give them advice, you know, go hang out, take them out.
The thing is, you know when you know someone has your best interest at hand?
Yeah.
Like, you can, like, even before I was paying them for anything, bro, I could be 16, come here, or I could even just be walking past, or let me pop in. He could look at me and say, you haven't cut your hair. Ah, bro, I don't even have my money. Come on, sit down, cut your hair, man. Go and look nice for the ladies. Basic stuff.
Yeah, this place, you enter here, you get haircuts, you get counseling session, once in a while, you can speak about
the same time, them lads, they worked very hard. You know, you give people opportunities, but they waste it. These lads, they make their own beats, write their own lyrics, do everything right, you know what I'm saying? So, big up to all of them, and wish them the best.
Come on, man.
You know what I'm saying? This is their fan TV, yeah? UK team,
Manchester.
Big up to the UK lads.
Outside.
Well, things are changing now, innit?
Yeah.
Link up. We shot. Link up. Wallad.
Literally here, innit? Along this whole page. You just had whips in that
block. Yeah, so you're the youngest as well, man.
Yeah.
So I love, why did you start rapping?
Bro, do you know how I started? It was because of Nick's. I was in Nick's yard at one point. Yeah. I'm not your son, I'm this guy here.
I don't like the hype. So basically, this guy's my son.
I was in his yard.
And he's very stupid.
He's just a wallad. So obviously, I was in his gaff. And I was just sitting around. And Nick's had like one, two audios out, yeah. So I just go, yeah, do you want to make a freestyle? Next day, like, yeah, say nothing. We did one Insta. Remember that Insta freestyle we did?
Yeah.
We did one Insta freestyle. I put on my Instagram. I had like 300 followers. I got like 2-3k views. I was gassed. So I was like, I can't say no more. I shouted to Safo. He's one of the managers before. He was trying to put me on. But obviously, I was young. So I was like, not really trying to do anything serious. So I just got a video done. What song was that I did? I did a quick freestyle with Kobe. Hi, but she loved AD like Digger. One wrong move and you might get sniped. Then to the deal. Yeah, we shut that down. We shut that down the deal. And after, I just released that from there. Shot my guy Morrison.
They told me you got a studio in your yard though.
Yeah, bro, I got a studio.
You're a proper music man, innit?
Yeah, because I was just seeing, like, obviously Kobe started off those studio ideas, yeah. Obviously, then he stopped to pursue videography and now he's gone to videography. So obviously there was a lack of studio in the end. So I was like, all right, calm. Put like what two bags into it, just decided to make a studio. Every time we just coming. We did like Next Up was done there.
Mamacita
was recorded there. Drop That with Nix was done there. Like best songs were done there. So that's what it's a blessing really. Do you get me?
See them kids, they pick up the litter on the block. So when there's fast cars, I swear my life.
Are you taking a piss?
I swear my life. Nah, I pay them kids to pick up the litter on the block. So.
Yeah, so I shall play my music video here. I was coming like UPS, age 15 when they told me their basics. Broke down buds and I said to the gym. There was bare man out and it was this during lockdown, so it was social distancing and that. We were obviously together. And a bully van just comes here, just spotted the block like four times, eventually packed up, came. was there recording the feds, yeah. Yeah. Just bleep out the name, bleep out the name. So obviously.
That's why he's stupid, isn't
it? Shut up, you wallad. So obviously, he peeped back the car. Feds came, he was recording the feds. The feds go saying that and they grabbed him. And he made a whole scene and then he posted on Instagram. The video went viral and everything as well. Him getting arrested. Just a bit mad, man.
I'll come here for a second though. Because before you were telling me about like you lot done your own like Black Lives Matter protest and that.
Oh, yeah.
What was that like?
So basically, what happened was, obviously, this wasn't for ends, but it was obviously a big marriage, you get me? I think somewhere in Dublin, I think it was in Blanche. One guy like this, obviously, there was something wrong with him.
I remember hearing about this.
Obviously, I don't know how the scene played out, but
they like, killed him. They killed him.
Police end up killing him.
Was it with a taser? Just like
no, they actually shot him. Oh,
something good for so,
yeah, he killed someone, didn't it?
Bro, that should show him a good. Yeah,
you know we forgotten about that, bro.
I think they shot him like three to five times.
Right. In his front guard like, in his eye, you know.
And bro, the guard like obviously the guy wasn't the guy that shot him wasn't in any danger at the time. You get what I'm saying? So it was only the thing was that I don't even think the guard got in major shit for it, like, do you know what I mean? There wasn't justice in the situation, so around the whole of Ireland, everyone was protesting. Mm-hmm. So I think,
yeah, I remember hearing about this.
What stuff. Was it? We were obviously like, okay, cool, it's not a guy from my ends, but we felt the pain, do you know what I mean? So we brought ourselves into town. I think we organized it. I think the first protest that we done was a bit quiet because everyone wasn't sure.
The second one, we organized it with the anti-Semitic.
You know what I mean? The second, the first one, people wasn't sure that, okay, cool, this was actually going to go ahead, because it didn't actually happen in ends. Mm. But we were like, nah, let's go down. So there's a few pictures from it. Obviously, I'll send it to you if you want to put it in. But we were doing our things as well, you know, making noise. We blocked off the whole street, man. It was a great turnout from in Drogheda anyway. And obviously, we put our part into the pain that that town was feeling. Yeah, that's what I mean. And actually supporting them.
What's this?
The protest. You know what I mean? So it was a huge problem. Do you know what I mean?
I remember when the George Floyd thing happened in America, and it's like obviously it opened a lot of people's eyes to like the way like police brutality. And obviously, yeah. I mean when the UK started protesting, Americans were like, oh, why are they protesting? You man can't relate. Yeah. Or like people don't know that shit is bad in the UK. The way police treat black people is crazy in the UK.
But then in
Ireland, obviously, I'm not gonna lie. Like a lot of people might not have known that. Like in Ireland, what's like the police brutality like in Ireland? Like?
In regards to that, police have messed up here. Like outside, yeah, they ain't gonna like. This was the first episode that I've seen outside. You know what I mean? That police had actually shot someone
and actually
killed them. Like led them to death. You know what I mean? At an early stage in their life. Mm. But like this was the first main one that was actually like put out there and actually caught on video.
Do you remember the parody that I threw, Grey Goose?
Yeah.
Right. Oh, so after, shit, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, you know, there's one guy, not really our boys, but Cool M, and his boys. He's from Dundalk, right, which is like 20-30 minutes away from here. Yeah, so they all came down to the party. Then the party got shot down, right? Like 2 hours into it, right? You know, rare people. Then feds came, right? Everybody started scattering, blah blah blah. And I don't even know what happened. But somehow they were grabbing this fella, and then they all the feds were grabbing, and then they all grabbed one fed, or they shoot the fed to the ground.
They beat the fed,
yeah. And then the feds grabbed one of this guy, and they took him to the cell, broke his phone, they fucked him up in the cell. Fucking, they were like, oh, they said some mad shit to him, bro. They said he was telling me, and then fucking. Then they let him out like the next day or so.
I swear he was even getting charged for everything.
Yeah, he was getting charged for the beating of the feds and all that. Oh. I don't even know what happened to the case. I think we all just dropped it. But it was fucked, bro.
Yeah, man. But like I was saying, like it wasn't before that incident in Blanche. It wasn't ever out on the street. Like, do you know what I mean? Nobody actually realized what it was because it was always quiet. And the good thing about the UK is that you guys have body cams. In Ireland, they don't have body cams, do you know what I mean? So they can do anything to you. I've seen it, like there's been times where me myself, like I ain't doing nothing, I'm walking around. I remember there was a big festival called The Fla. Mm. I ain't doing too much, and fans will come up to me. They all surrounded me, do you know what I mean? I went to go take out my phone, rip my phone out of my hand, do you know what I mean? So in regards to that, when they're on you, like, do you know what I mean? Other than that, sometimes they can mind their business, I think on Garda Shia Khan, I mean, it's like the guardian of peace. And like, you can say, like, that's the Irish guy now. You can say that, to be honest, I say they keep pieces in some parts, but like when it comes to like races,
they are ass. They took my car off me so many fucking times just because of one simple. Like it's fucked.
Yeah, bro. Do you know what I mean? I'm
pretty sure that's officer and Southpaw pulling up now. Yeah, so yeah, we're gonna go chat to them, man. I'm pulled up like £1 million right now. Look at that car.
Billy.
I said manager for manage.
We're working.
Oh, come on.
We're working. Hey, shout out Billy the Go for coming to chat.
Nah, come on. Trust me, it's only right, but chat to us, man. What have you and officer got coming soon, man?
Big things, bro. We've got a lot of plans coming. The rest of the A9 too as well, obviously. K-Sav's doing his thing and just the rest of the A9.
So have you like been, obviously Morrison told me that you might have been involved like from the jump as well, yeah?
Yeah, but he's been involved.
Oh yeah, but you kind of came in a bit after. Oh shit. Alright, show that dog.
This thing is massive.
Massive, no.
Where's MC's one?
Good, yeah?
I did.
Say about it, you came out to the block.
We're matching, innit?
Come on.
We're matching, man.
Obviously you say you're the superstar of the group right now. You don't like claiming that one?
You are, man.
What? So look, chat to me, like, obviously since life has changed for you, like, have you like stayed local or are you like kind of out of the mix right now?
Well, me and Safo literally just came back from Dublin, innit?
Well, say that.
We're going shopping. Nah, bro. Have fun.
Hey, round two.
Man, I got. Good, yeah. Chillin'.
Man, they were telling me that like you were like the one that kind of spared everyone else to do the music thing as well. Yeah. So like from you, see when you first started off here, yeah, like what was it that made you want to do music?
I more have done it for fun, like.
Oh, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It wasn't even like, I was playing football back then. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, straight up.
Nick started making music before everybody.
Straight up.
Yeah. And yeah, like I was doing exams around that time. I showed PT something I rapped, innit?
Yeah.
He was like, yeah, that's cool, innit? And we went to the studio and kind of like
feel you.
Done it.
Like man can even hear in your bars, like you just have fun with it, you get me? Like your thing is like very like kind of like playful, innit? You get me? Not taking life too seriously. Mm. Obviously, when you do that on drill, yeah, it's like it comes with a thing where like people might not take you as seriously of a drill up in the game. Like have you felt that or you don't really care about that?
Nah, I feel like people take us seriously. Like if you know us, innit?
Yeah.
Like obviously as a driller, people expect you to be like every single time, but it's not like that, do you know what I mean? People are just steady, man, trying to be going about business and stuff, and everybody's really business minded as well, so like that's not gonna take you anywhere if that's your mindset for life, do you know what I mean?
Nah, I feel you, but obviously you're a guy that you like set pace in Ireland, you get me? You've done a lot of things that people thought Irish couldn't do, you feel me? You got a fan of me, you got the biggest club in ever, you got some of KSI, so like in your head, yeah, is there things that you want to do like they've not done yet? Like what would you say like your next goals they want to achieve?
Probably to be more of a like international artist. Like I feel like they know me in Ireland.
They know you in the UK as well, man. Keep him away or keep him away. Don't bring him near me. Don't bring him near me. This guy's violent. Don't bring him near me or what's wrong?
Niggas really don't like dogs.
Yeah man, obviously that's the end of the episode. Comment down below who else you want me to get on Trenchtalkz. So obviously we're here with all the boys right now. So if you got anything you guys want to promote, anything you got coming soon, you get me?
Obviously I've got my solo, I'm starting my solo career. So
soon!
I've got something, my first track innit, coming very soon. When's it coming? Come now.
Coming soon.
Coming soon. Manager said it, coming soon.
Yo,
Chris out right now.
Red Cup, coming soon. Red Cup coming soon. Wait on it.
Red Cup. Wait.
Obviously, I got Royal Ball coming soon as well. Skip House coming soon as well. Is it next week as well?
Yo, you lot keep streaming Crease though. Keep streaming Crease for the remix. Remix comes soon.
Skip House next week.
I obviously got it for coming soon, my bro.
Yo.
Everything.
People come to. You know about it.